and welcome to Sanjeev Kapoor Khazana. I'm Anupa and I'm going to be sharing with you some really exciting recipes. In the past, I have shown quite a few pasta recipes. This one also is a unique recipe. I'm going to be showing you how to make penne chicken in Alfredo sauce. Very, very creamy sauce and tastes just perfect. For this, I need some ingredients. So let's quickly run through them. I need about 2 cups of boiled penne or macaroni. 2 to 3 spring onions. We need 1 each of green, yellow and red pepper. About a cup full of white sauce. 1 blanched tomato cut into fine strips. 1 chicken breast cut into cubes. 2 tablespoons of oil. Few sprigs of parsley. Salt to taste. 3 to 4 cloves of garlic. 2 tablespoons of parmesan cheese. 1/4 cup of cream. 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper powder. So let's begin. First of all, let's use a wok, and while this is getting heated, let's quickly prep our vegetables. I need some spring onions. I need the 3 peppers. Make sure your knife is absolutely sharp. So first, let's cut the onion. We need to keep the green and the white separate. Cut this into slices like this. Spring onion is quite tender, so even if you bite into it, it doesn't taste very pungent. So which is why I prefer to leave it a little thick while I'm using it in any kind of food, be it pasta or any other Chinese food. So this is the spring onion, and the green I'm going to cut like this. So this is the green, so that's it. We'll all keep it here, the spring onion white and the spring onion green. Before that, let's do one thing. Let's add some oil to this wok. And I have chicken with me, but the chicken here is raw. We have to saute this on high heat so that it retains its moisture. And when you serve it with the pasta, it tastes perfect. So let's add some salt to this and some pepper powder. Okay, that's it. Salt and pepper powder is what you need to marinate the chicken with. I'm not really marinating it, I'm just mixing it. And before we add any other vegetables to the oil, we will first sear the chicken and we will first cook it partially. That's very important because chicken would take a little longer to cook as compared to the other vegetables. So we will cook this first. And also you'll save out a lot of time if you are cooking the chicken at the same time prepping your vegetables. So the oil is hot, here goes the chicken. That's it. Let it cook till it is nicely done. It should be soft. Make sure it doesn't turn brown. So you got to have a look at the chicken at the same time while you're doing your vegetables. Now we have the peppers which we have to cut into strips. Like this. So this is the yellow pepper. We'll have a look at the chicken. This is about partially done. We'll further cook it for a minute or so. That's it, slightly underdone, because finally when it cooks with the pasta and the sauce, it'll taste perfect. More important here is to keep the chicken moist. So if you overcook the chicken, it goes dry and it doesn't taste good. And moreover, because we are using boneless pieces of chicken, which is the breast piece is quite tender as long as you don't overcook it. So if you cook it even slightly longer, it tends to go dry and that's when you find it a problem. Moreover, if you use a leg piece of chicken, which is a boneless, it's easier. But if you are a little health conscious, then I would suggest that you go with the boneless breast piece. So the chicken is done. We'll put it back into the same bowl. Now, after the yellow pepper, let's cut the red pepper and also the green. This also we have to cut into julienne, slightly thick like this. Yes, so this is with the red. Now we'll cut the green. As a chef, is what we've learned, and one relates with these vegetables with an Alfredo sauce. So obviously when someone says Alfredo, you're not going to make it in a red sauce. you will definitely make it with a white sauce, and you'll have peppers, you'll have spring onions in it, sometimes even tomato, and yes, I'm going to be using it. Peppers are done. Now we'll need little bit of garlic, very little, just about little bit of garlic, and but this needs to be chopped nice and fine like this. That's it. Now let's take some more oil to this, and in this we'll add the spring onion, we'll add the garlic and all the three peppers. This looks very, very colorful. To this we'll add little bit of salt, and we'll leave the peppers slightly crunchy but not raw. So just give it a light toss. Peppers have a lot of moisture, so when you have to cook them, make sure you cook them on high heat, otherwise they wilt very fast and they go absolutely limp. That's it. Now to this we'll add the pasta, we'll add the chicken. We've already added salt, and we had also added salt to the chicken, so I'm sure we have enough salt in this. However, while we are serving this, we will again check for seasoning. You see this? It's looking so colorful. Now in case of this sauce, I've used peppers which I have cut into julienne, because my pasta is also a long pasta. If you were to use a farfalle or a bow macaroni, you could cut the peppers into squares or dices. That's very simple. The reason that I've cut it this way is because when you eat a pasta, you can also eat it along with the peppers, which is why I have cut it this way. Choice is yours if you wish to cut it in a different size. Now to this, we'll add tomatoes. These are blanched tomatoes, and they are further cut into strips like how we've cut the peppers. Just that here we have deseeded the tomato and we've peeled it after we've blanched it. If I were to have it, I would have it just like this without any sauce. But since we are making an Alfredo, we have to add white sauce to this. So here we go. Some white sauce here. A very important rule or a thumb rule while you make a pasta. Once you have boiled the pasta and kept it in a bowl, make sure you apply oil to it. Another important thing is that when you are cooking a pasta in a pan, use a pan like this, which is quite broad, and at the same time do not keep on mixing it with a spoon. As far as possible, try and toss it, or if you have to use the spoon, make sure you use it just once or twice. Like we've added the pasta, we've added the sauce, just one mix and out. Pasta is already cooked, so it doesn't need much of cooking. Similarly with the vegetables and the white sauce. In this, I'm going to be switching it off because everything is just done. I'm not going to be mixing it again and again because the pasta will then break, and then it doesn't give a very good look to the dish. So this is done. If you feel that the white sauce that you've added has gone a little too thick, you could add some milk to this and thin it down, and just before service, add little cream, like I'm going to be doing it here. That's it. So let's serve this in a very attractive looking bowl, and we'll garnish it with the spring onion. So after adding the spring onion, let's sprinkle some Parmesan cheese. No pasta is complete without adding any cheese. Well, I'm going to be adding Parmesan because this gives it the best flavor. Chicken pasta and Alfredo sauce is ready. Make this recipe just the way I have made it and you'll love it.